Just about everyone has a beginning of the pandemic moment. Maybe it was the closing of an office building or the sight of empty shelves at the grocery store. No matter the occurrence, it was the time we felt the seriousness of the situation. For many, it's the one-year anniversary of that feeling. On March 11th, 2020, the coronavirus outbreak was labeled a pandemic. Within days, in-person gatherings, such as the celebration of Mass, were suspended. NC Catholics Now begins in Goldsboro at St. Mary Church, where Father Rock remembers turning people away.
I was out there on the church's parking lot, and instead of getting everybody ready for Mass, I was telling people to go home. As a Catholic priest, I stood outside of the church, turning people away from Mass. Not everybody got the message the night before, so quite a few people still came to Mass on Sunday morning, and we had to tell them to go home. And so that was sad. It was traumatic also. But then eventually we had to learn to live with it, and then a week later we celebrated Mass, live streaming online.
When everything is said and done, Jesus always asks us, do you believe?
If you had told me last year that we'd have an entire crew and could do this on our own, I probably would have laughed quite heartily. Here at Holy Name of Jesus Cathedral, we had never really live streamed anything on our own before the shutdown. We had to not only order our own equipment and get everything all set up, we then needed to recruit some members. We needed to train. We also needed to figure out how to do this and what was the best method. We have a crew of between 8 and 10 members of our stream team, and each week we have a team of 2 per Mass.
How does it feel to be a part of that?
It is really overwhelming, the enormity of, one, the responsibility, but also the privilege that we get to do this. When we see people logging on from, you know, Asia and far reaches of the globe, it's pretty amazing to know that our little production here is touching the world.
The worst part for people was we closed the church. And I think for the majority of the people, this one was the experience to feel like that we take something that they needed. We had to create other alternatives, other things in order to answer for this one. But this was the first experience for me, was this one, was emptiness. People start listening, people participate, people register in YouTube, and thanks for the support of many people. In all these moments, always we have a great lessons. One of these ones that we try to promote in our community is that we are not alone, is we are together.
Father Fernando said his parish reached people not only through streaming Mass, but through virtual events such as the Rosary and Stations of the Cross. In Raleigh, Father Phil Hurley had a similar experience, and he also recalls the first weekend of live streaming.
It was very low tech. Our experience was really something that first weekend. It was just on one of our staff leaders on his phone, you know, just on his phone set there. And I think he was able to connect it with the sound system of the church. He's amazing with that stuff. So we had that. I really thought at a couple points during the Mass, I thought, I don't know if this is working at all. Like, I'm just going to keep going, but I guess it's live streaming. I'm not sure. You know, it was kind of a new technology for me as well. So after the Mass, after we finished and, you know, the live stream stopped, I walked over across the church to the team that had been doing the recording and all. And I said, well, how did it go? And I saw, I'm not going to name her because she'd be embarrassed, but one of our leaders had, I saw she had tears in her eyes. Oh. And I thought, oh no. I said, oh, did it not work? Did it not work at all? And she said, no, it's the opposite. It worked. Like the stream went through the whole time, but she proceeded to tell me how amazed she was at the people that came on. I think it was just Facebook that first weekend. We used our Facebook page, and the comments that people had put on at different parts of the Mass and typing in the responses.
When asked how the first few weeks of quarantine impacted his parish, he points to new ways of doing things, such as the new Hands and Feet Ministry, which cares for people in need with things like dropping off groceries and telephone conversations. He also mentioned the virtual atrium, which allowed parishioners to chat together online after Mass.
As with any crisis moment, it's been an experience of big challenges, but also hidden opportunities and blessings. And I would say it's been a time, not that this has been easy, it's actually been mostly difficult, but it's been a time for us to really live out some of our core values as a parish.
That's all for now. Visit nccatholics.org and dioceseofraleigh.org this month for stories from the past year. Look for the headline 1 year later. Take care, and thanks for watching.